Hi, I'm Kuba, and this time we'll build a feature store with Apache Iceberg. Moreover, we'll use a real-time ingestion mechanism based on the Kafka Connect to feed offline store. Apache Iceberg is a high-performance table format which can be used for a huge analytics datasets. Iceberg offers several features like schema evolution, partition evolution and hidden partitioning, and many more which can be used to effectively process petabytes of data. Thus, Apache Iceberg is perfect to use as an historical store. That's why I have decided to integrate it with FIST feature store through YAMI extension. But how to build a historical feature store which will be ingested in the real time from multiple data sources? To do this, I will use Kafka Connect and Iceberg Sync. This can be used to build Iceberg Lake on on-premise S3 store or to move your data and build a feature store in the cloud. Let's follow the end-to-end solution. The whole example is available on GitHub. You can simply reproduce it using the Docker environment. Suppose we have our transactional system based on the Postgres database, where we keep current clients' features. The Kafka Connect will use the Bisium Postgres connector to track every data change and put it to the Iceberg using Iceberg Sync. We'll store Iceberg tables on the Minio S3 store, but of course you can use AWS S3. Kafka Connect is based on Kafka, thus we'll also need a Kafka instance and Zookeeper. We'll track features changes to build historical feature store. Kafka Connect will publish databases changes to the Kafka, thus we also need to create appropriate topics if we don't have topics auto-creation enabled. Now we can set up Postgres connector and Iceberg Sync through Kafka Connect API. In the Postgres connector, we need to specify a list of tables which we want to track. In the next step, we'll post Iceberg Sync configuration where we specify the topics to read and also table and S3 store configuration. Kafka Connect is ready, thus we'll simulate database changes using generated data. We will split features into two tables. Because the Bisium has a wide range of integrations, you can also use other databases like MySQL, MongoDB, Oracle, SQL Server or DB2. Let's start with feature store configuration YAML. Currently, you can use Iceberg with the Spark backend. You can also add additional Spark configuration such as catalog configuration or S3 store configuration. In the next step, you have to add Iceberg data source. In the feature store definition, you specify a path to Iceberg table or table name, which you want to consume on the file system or S3 store respectively. Of course, you can combine the Iceberg data source with other data sources like packets, CSV files, or even Delta Lake if needed. Now we are ready to apply feature store definition and fetch historical features. You can find the whole code on GitHub and detailed description on my blog and Yummy documentation, thus it should be relatively simple to reproduce all steps with the Docker. That's all for today, please subscribe and thanks for watching, bye!